Repeat after me. Vitur. In Icelandic, when someone is very wise, you say that person is vitur. It means they have a lot of wit or sense. And the opposite of that, when someone isn't wise at all, they're vitli singur. It means that person doesn't have any vit. Essentially, they're witless or vitless. A recent study found that learning new words activates the same brain region that's active when you do pleasurable activities like eating cake or seeing your favourite band perform. I hope you found vitli singur mind-blowing. In this study, researchers gave participants two tasks. One was learning new words, and the other was a gambling task. fMRI scans showed that the ventral stratum, a key area involved in reward and motivation, was active in both tasks. It kind of makes sense because communicating with people gives us pleasure. Research suggests that through human evolution, we were motivated to acquire linguistic skills and learn language because it's tied to this reward system. As you can see, I'm in Iceland. It's a really geologically young country, so the landscapes here have been mind-blowing. We describe things as mind-blowing all the time, but what does it actually mean? The Oxford Dictionary defines mind-blowing as something overwhelmingly impressive. The Free Dictionary as something intensely affecting your emotions, and the Urban Dictionary as something so mind-boggling you're shocked senseless. The emotional aspect is interesting because we need emotion to engage our learning cycle. Research suggests that we learn best when we're in a state of relaxed awareness. We're not too aroused and we're not totally disengaged. When you go to watch a video on YouTube, chances are you're comfortable and challenged. Learning happens best when you're in this mood and you experience awe and curiosity. Perhaps that's why you're more likely to comment on something and say it's mind-blowing than in real life. I have another idea that when we learn cool bits of information and awesome facts, we activate that same reward region of our brain as when we learn new words. You feel good because you've learned something cool and you want to learn more. It's the mind-blown cycle. If only researchers would put participants in an fMRI machine and let them watch a Vsauce video.
I've been wondering the same thing.
Like personal communication and language, acquiring new knowledge is what defines us as humans. Sure, other animals learn things too, but we record it and we share it verbally. All of this suggests that curiosity is contagious, and it's kind of addictive too. Learning new words activates that reward area of our brain, and perhaps learning surprising new bits or vits of information does too. It's kind of mind-blowing. Let me know what you think in the comments and if you've experienced some vitur during this video. I'll be back next Thursday for another brainy episode. This is one of only two places in the world where you can actually see the Earth's tectonic plates meet up. There's two here. Over on my left is the North American plate, and over on the right is the Eurasian plate. It's pretty mind-blowing. We're standing, my hood keeps falling down.
200 types of bacteria in here, a new species.